Wow, welcome guys, Smithy here, welcome to another episode of Jurassic World. But, what's this? Where's this from? What's this? There's a track on my world, but however, it's not my world guys. There's two tracks on my world. We've got the mud track, and we have a gravel track. What did I see then? What did I see? This is not my world. Nope, I must have accidentally clicked someone else's world. I must have gone there. So where are we? Well, this is a super duper world, which I wasn't going to film, but as soon as I came on, I thought, I'm going to have to show you. What's this? Oh, run like mad. Where are we? Someone else's Jurassic World. Wow, look at that. Absolutely brilliant, guys. Now, I saw this, and I haven't had a tour yet. I was just looking at how the roads have been done, and he left the Avery on, and you can see this is a Jurassic World Isle of Nublar 1-1 by Austin. That's his real name, but his planet Minecraft name is Revenue, and I'll put a link in the bottom of the description. This is something that he has been working on for a while, and I've been in contact with him, and this is the first time I've had chance to actually look at it. And this is, yeah, look at this. Now, he left this on the island because I said, oh, I'd love to see that. But you can see that this island has roads on, which is pretty cool. I'm really impressed with this. And this is definitely a 1-1 scale island, I assure you. So I haven't been anywhere around it yet or looking at it. So let's just get out of that mode, and we're still in shaders. Oh, that's not the right mode either. There we go, we're back. So we are down one part of the island by the Avery, which is pretty good, isn't it? I do like it. I do like the trees, and look, it's got hillsides and stuff as well. In fact, let's go higher. In fact, what I need to do is put on to 32 chunks. That's what I think I'll do. I'm just gonna do that and come back. So here we are at the lagoon, and as I say, I'm just doing a sneak peek on this episode because I want to get back to building. Ah, horses here, that's funny. This is the lagoon, which is roughly about the same size as the original one. And there's plenty of room here to paste in my map. I say I'm gonna try it on this map, but not until we finish doing the Pachycephalosaurus arena, and we finish with what is that, bedrock. Yeah, until we finish with the main street area, but I might try it just for ending anyway. So there's loads and loads of room at the back here for the water park, because the mountains don't start right here, so there's plenty of room for the innovation center and stuff as well. Yeah, it would actually fit in very well. I wonder where the helipad needs to go up quite high up on the hill here somewhere. That's not high enough for a helipad. Needs to go up a bit to overlook. Yeah, that needs to sort of build on top of there, or on the mountain over here somewhere, as we go up and up and up and up and up. We'll have to see how it fits in, see what it looks like on the map. I'm gonna give it a go, give it a try and see. What I'm gonna do is we're gonna head back to my Isle of Nublar and continue building. So thank you very much indeed to allow me to go on this map, and I'm sure we're gonna see a bit more of it. And I've also got another map which he's been building on as well, because I'm gonna do a showcase on his builds, Jurassic World builds, in the next couple of episodes. Right, let's go and head back to my world then. However, before we just nip back to my world, I just want you to show this one, the most amazing part of the map. And you will all recognise this as where the boys jumped off into the pool. This is just amazing. I tweeted this last night because it was so impressive. Look at that. Literally turned out brilliant in that little area which has been done. Literally where they jumped off there into the pool and they climbed and clawed their way out over here, which is well cool and really, really impressive. So I thought you might want to see that. Most excellent, I must admit. Excellent piece of work. So yeah, that's it. We are now going to go and finish our Pachycephalosaurus arena while the sun sets on New Nublar. There's lots of more little treasures to find on this map. There's some super cool stuff which I haven't shown you. And we'll be back on for another video with that. But let's head back to my map. So welcome back. And we're going to do some more work now on the arena. Because I keep sort of adjusting it. I'm going to have to adjust it again, really. I think it needs to come out a little wider now at the bottom. So I need to read it. Well, that was the original one. This is the next one. But I still feel that it needs a bit more. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with this one over here. Literally, we're going to use this outer rim here as the way it comes up in terms of from this point onwards, I'm going to start using big blocks. So that's the case I'm going to have to do. It's just the way it is. And I'm going to put these in and it doesn't matter. But this is what I'm going to do. It's going to take a little bit of time, like. But I think we're going to get it. And it's just a case of going one round all the way and then redoing it just to make it better than it is. It's easier to do it this way because I keep building and placing blocks against the blocks behind. It's just easier to do it. So I'm going to do this one first because now I know this is not going to be the right size. We're going to start there. Ooh, that's not right. That should have been there. And it's just a case of going along here and going back. So what we're going to do is I'm going to take you through this as I go through it. Yeah, there we go. And what I can do see is I can build up around this and then take the old one out as such. That's about it, really. And then I should get it right this time. I don't want it too high, though. It can go way too high. But once we get this in, I might have to put some blocks in front of it now and make it come down even more. Might have to do some major alterations there. So that's that. That starts it. Yeah, look. I'm looking at the long range and short range, and the pictures are slightly different on each one. But you know me, I like to get it right. I really do like to put a lot of effort into it. That's two. That's one. That's one, so that comes around for two, so we have to watch that out. Right, so that is where we start doing that. Yeah, that's actually probably just about right, and I need to come there. And you can see that that's the way it works. Yeah. So that's going to be my base. So what I'm going to have to do is going to copy the same for both. And then I'll come back and show you how it's actually looking once we get a bit closer to getting it done. Because I don't want to waste loads of time filming when I've got loads of other stuff to do. Got to bring two more dinos. Look at the baby dinos. Oh, the first escapees are out. And oh my, where's that big one come from? Oh, I never got rid of it, did I? The first escapees have nipped through the glass. This is the sort of thing I'm going to get all the time. But hey, I'll sort it out and make sure we keep these back in. Right, I think I'm being clever here because I need to do both at the same time to get the actual shape. What I need to do is it's much tighter and sharper on this side at the point, but because it's between two areas, it's a shallower on this side, so we're sort of going wider. So the best way is to do both at the same time to build them up and get the actual shape right. I've also changed the shape of this bit here as well. And then what it means is I can put some extra blocks in. But the crucial thing is that we keep the square line that way and also the square line this way. It's not quite right yet, but it will be on the next way I do it. So it's just slightly off. That one's right and that one isn't. A bit weird that one's off. Oh, I see, I made that come out. Did I make that come out wider? Anyway, it's still going to look pretty good when I finished. You can't tell once it gets going. So, and it should then come up much higher like we wanted to. Not too high though. It's not a massively high tent. Also, the fact you got to remember, this is a tarpaulin. So there's only so much you can do with stretching tarpaulin. But there you go. You can see that we're getting a good shape as we go along. It's just about making sure I do both at the same time, fill them all in, and as you can see, yeah, it's coming along nicely. So we should be back shortly again once I do a bit more. It's getting easier as we go around. As long as I keep the same for both sides, it will end up really good. So there you go, just needed to show you what I was actually doing. But the trouble is I've got to knock out all these center blocks as well as I go along, and I'm going to do some fancy bit at the front of here and front of here to make sure it still carries on being a circle as well. I just love this waterfront at night time. In terms of the decision I made a while back to light it all up, it's going to be fun when we put the new map. Anyway, back to this. This has taken me ages. Dinosaurs are alright in the petting zoo. Got a bit more lighting to do in there to finish lighting it up, but you can see now what it looks like in the dark. I have increased the size astronomically. It is now the right size compared with the point, I mean, on this side. Three times I've upped the size of the point. It's now the right size to this particular area. Once the trees are up and that, it's going to look pretty good. So what I want to do is show you the nighttime really and show you how it looks, because I've spent hours on it. I've rebuilt it, I've knocked it down, I've come back, and I've now got this little pinnacle here. I've got a bit more to do, but at least now I can and look, if you think about it now, this was the puny little one we had before, which is still here. It was just puny blocks. And you can see now it's much more substantial. I don't want to get it go any bigger than that though. It's now got the right size. Exactly. So what I'm going to do now is turn time set day. Hopefully I'll get that. There we go. We'll put it back into daylight. Yeah, I've reached. So what I'm going to do now is I'm now going to make the second pillar the same. It's been very difficult because I've had to, as I say, reshape it. I was listening to the Jurassic World podcast last night. It's absolutely brilliant. It's well worth it. Excellent, really good discussion on the new movie and the old and what they didn't like about the old. There's some opposing views, which was really fun, really interesting to watch. So what I'm going to do is literally now I've got a copy. I've been trying to literally get it identical on both sides and all the way around the back here as well. So, and let me just show you from the inside, because I haven't actually been inside. You can now see that was the old one with the lighting, and this is the new one again, which is far bigger than that one over there. So it looks pretty good from over here. It is a circus tent, and it does have this area in the middle. That's the whole point, the way it's designed. It's designed as a circus tent, and it's also tied to all these stilts at the same size, and it does match the pictures, I assure you. If you have a look at the pictures, it has got a very flat roof from the over the top. So it's designed as an arena with a pointy roof on. So what I'm going to do now is say I'm just going to put some more on, and then we shall come back, and I've got a couple more dinos to put in over there and light up as well. Yes, well, here we have it. I have finished the roof. I am not going to change it anymore. I'm very happy with it. It matches. Might not be traditional as a way, but it does match exactly what the graphics and everything shows. What I've done though is started to light up the area, because I've just done some shots on Twitter, and to light up the walking area there around the side. When it's daylight, I'm going to start putting some trees in as well. So let's just head down here. It's finished. You can see it will look the same in the daylight, but you can see it, and so we're now completely finished. I've put the extra lighting on it. What I was doing though was just finishing it off. Now I think I'll leave the character there. I think that's superb. Yeah, I think I've done that. So that's the area there. So what I'm going to do right at the end is I think I might transport this into 1.89 just for fun, to see how the Pachycephalosaurus will look in the 1.89 version. Yeah, I think I might do that. So right, anyway, come back to, and if we go right over here, it now fits into the world excellently. It really does fit in. But what I need to do is just do some, just going to put a few more trees and lighting in here. Remember what I did over there with the greenery? So I think I need some water, I need some grass, and I need, oh, I could put a jungle sapling in this one because it's quite big. Oh, lighting we need to get rid of that and that there. There we go. So like this area, the biggest area that we need to sort of light up is here. So it's just a case of, you know, do this in dark. It makes a lot of sense to do this. And then I can just do this, put the water in, and then I can put a light, if I'm clever, if I just, and do that one there, do that one there. Oh, like that. Oh, it's coming daylight. Let's just get it back to night time again. So we're doing this properly, as I say. Put that in there, and then all I have to do is, very clever, if I sort of make that there, there, like that, and then put, literally put a tree on the corner here, make it go big. There we go. And then literally, if I put a bit of light in there like that, that literally lights it up. And even if I now make, see, and we hide it, it still shines through. So it's a bit of clever light in there. And then all I need to do is, what I did over there is just put some bushes down. Don't I? We're a bit more water over here, I think, actually, if I'm clever. So if we just do, it's always good to have a bit of water. And then literally just bring that over here. Sorry about that, a bit of a sneezing fit then. So there we go there. What I just need to do is put the light in there and there, but I didn't continue to do the lighting round here in this bit. You can see that I didn't actually put the sand in. So what I'll do first of all is just put the lighting in around the pen walkway. You can see where the walkway has got the lighting round, and this is just missing some lighting as it is. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go around, light this up, put the sand in, and then we will work towards putting in our other two little creatures. One's going to be one that was recommended, and the other one's going to be slightly different than we usually put in these parks. And then finally I can come and put the trees in. What I might just do now is just put a few more trees in. Now I'm going to have a look at the palm tree, because it might be good. Oh, that's no good. Have we got any of those left? Oh, lucky me. Yeah, that's better, isn't it? That's better. That's what we want, to light it up, because we want the whole part lit up. See, all these little bits take time and energy, and you have to do them manually. But so what I'm going to do is I shall come back shortly once I've done the rest. Well, welcome back, everybody. I've started to put some trees in, and if you remember, right over there on my I built some trees based on the old fossil and archaeology mod. So these are more like palm trees now. What I've done is put them at different heights, because what I want to do is mix the trees in. These are palm trees as such. I want to do a mixture of trees around the park in terms of this area. So you can see I've just done these here, and then over here I've started doing the trees around here. So I didn't want to put too many of these trees in, because most of the trees around this part of the park are quite thinly spaced and are a lot lower. But you can see what I'm trying to establish, trying to put some trees in of different types. We've got the bigger ones, which I'm going to put in a minute, but I wanted to just show you before I started decorating a landscape, and I wanted to get the, I've used MC Edit. What I did is put the tree trunks going up, and then literally I placed the palm trees on top, just gives you that effect. They will be here when you download the map, so they're not going to disappear. So who's down here now? So the idea is when you're walking around, you've got palm trees here. Who's this? Jurassic Gamer. Hello. Oh, looks like an evil android. So what I want to do now is put a few more trees in to a lower level now to sort of sprinkle them around. So I'm going to use the let's see how this works. If I put one here in the middle, just here, we'll see if this works. Single one's usually very good. There you go. I just want to put one or two here because there's not supposed to be, on the particular map, there's not supposed to be many trees. But I felt that we should actually put a few more because the new pathway will be walking around and you would definitely see some trees here. Sometimes they're small like that, sometimes they're high. So it's just to put some trees around to make it more interesting. I need to put some here. Oh, we'll slip up a couple in here. So these are just normal trees, just to make it a bit more realistic as such. There we go. So what I'm going to do is spend a little bit of time decorating some more trees. And then I should come back. I just want to make it more landscape than it ever has been over this side. It'll take me a while. It takes me a while to do those, so I'll be back once I put a few more trees in. Right, so here we go, everybody. I've added the landscape in. I've been putting various trees in, as you know. I used my own, and I've started putting in, looking at the overhead shots of the park, and sort of really putting the clusters of trees where they're going. So it looks way better than it's ever has done before. And let me just show you over here. So I've put in some more, because we don't know what exactly we're going to do over here. I've put in some big trees as shown, but there are, looking on the far reaching picture, there are some more shots just here, but I don't think we're going to do those quite yet because I've got to finish off this area. And I've put it out to 32 blocks. That's why you can see everything going way back over there. But just start, even my GTX 970, it starts taking it down. And someone asked, see the line? See that line? I cannot get rid of it. It's since I've had the GTX, so it's an NVIDIA thing rather than AMD. Wow, look at that over there. See, it's mad. Anyway, you can see now that I've put in trees around the petting zoo. And what I've done is if we go down a lot closer, it really does, if we come now here, it really does start to look like a park. And I've put loads and loads of trees in here, and I've put all the grass and stuff as well. And I've added some more trees in where the dinos are, so I just need to do some sorting out there. You can see now the 32 chunks have kicked in. Great for taking pictures, but not so brilliant, even with this i7 and this 970 GTX running at full whack. It's still taking up a lot of stuff. So we've done this bit round here. I've not put all the trees in yet. I might do something more, but I put in the most of the trees until I finish it off. I've started putting trees here because this pathway, let me just bring back, let me just, I was going to take a snap of this for Twitter because I just wanted to show people what it looked like because people do like it. You should follow me on Twitter, everybody. You get good snaps before it gets uploaded. So I've got to do the pathway around here. That looks way better, doesn't it? That looks way better now we've started to add the trees in. I must admit it does. It does look good. Let's just take that back off to here. Yeah, so the pathway, the water park is set right back here. But because until basically I'm not going to do the water park until we after episode 200, when I literally paste this onto the new Island Nubla map, which means the mountains go much further back, which is way better because it means I can do the monorail station. I can do the monorail over there without cutting into the mountain. The monorail station comes from over there, comes round, cuts right through that mountain here, but it won't do. Then the water park, you can get some perspective now. See that white path over there? Well, there's a load of trees here where I'm pointed to in the center. It's a white path, and then it leads on to the water park. Now, at the moment, if I did the water park here, what I haven't done yet is a death slide. The death slide runs Literally, yes, it does. It literally runs up through here to the water park, and the water park would be over here on this map. Now, what I might, well, I can't do really, because I need to be able, I can't build any further than this for when I copy and paste it so into the new map, and I'll have loads more space to build the rest of the park. And I know loads of you've been waiting for the water park. I will build the water park. It is going to be cool. Yeah, I can do that. It's pretty big. I can do that quite easily, but I can't build it because I need to, when I've tried it out, I need to cut all out there and then paste this into the new map, and then we're on our way with a one-to-one map, which is so cool. Superb. So I'm going to make this available first, though, in terms of the lake area, and just sell the island. So what else we got to do? Right, to finish off then, two new dinosaurs. One dinosaur and one non-dinosaur to bring in to finish off the petting zoo as such. So we're back very shortly. Right, so here we go. I've changed my mind. I found the other little dino that I want to put into here. So let's go down. One of the ones that requested, and thank you very much, that was well cool, was the Protoceratops. Because it's cute and small, so I think what we'd do is put a few around in here and see how things go. We're all right. Look at them. Wee, off you go. Oh, the pigs are not getting in, but we'll put a couple in here for you. So let's have a look. I'll put a baby in. Look how small the babies are. Let's put a full size one in. Yeah, because look at that. That's the biggest they grow. So it's absolutely great for a petting zoo, is it not? Although I wouldn't like to touch these quills on the back. Probably get told off, but they look like quills. Wouldn't like to do that. Let's see if we can get the other one out. Yes, the second Protoceratops. Aren't they gorgeous? My mate had these in his Jurassic Park San Diego. Rolo MC put them into Jurassic Park San Diego, and they're very cute, aren't they? We love them. They are so cute. Just put a couple more babies in here. Whee! Look at them go. Yeah, these I've got to be, because of the colours and everything, he's got to be one of my favourite dinos. They are cute. We just don't get round to putting them all in because we do too much building. So what I'm going to endeavour over the run up to episode 200, we've got a few more to go, is let's look at some more dinos. We need to pay one more visit back to Isla Sauna. We need a bit more stuff, but that thing over there has taken the whole week to build. Yeah, but never mind. It's all good. It's all good. Let's get some time back. Time set day. So let's put a couple more in the other pen. Hey, we didn't get much in here, did we? God, these are growing. I'm going to have to send them out to the fields and put some new ones in because they're getting way too big. And put some Protoceratops in there. They are gorgeous, Apatosaurus. I do believe, what new dinosaur are we getting? They're working on some new dinosaurs as well. Go and check out the Jurassicraft 2 forum, and also follow some of the guys on Twitter. They are making some new super dinosaurs as well. They're so good. I love them. Right, and finally, for this little area here, we need a little dino. I was going to put a mammal in here, but I'm not, because last time I put the mammals in the park, they went under the innovation center and disappeared. So we're going to put in the Microceratus. I think we can just about get them in here without dying. So I'm going to put a full size one in first of all. Look at that. Aren't they gorgeous? I think I did them over there. Did I not do them over there by the little zoo? Yeah, as they're full size, I think we're going to leave them like that. Aren't they cute? There's one. They're both the same there, aren't they? Should we get another one? Nope. Hold on a second. That's really red. We see. Yay! There you go. There's the other one. And look at the detail in these. That is just gorgeous. I love them. They're great, aren't they? Absolutely superb. They're ideal for this pen because they can go up here. Hopefully they won't sort of die in any way and fall off the edge. Probably find them running around the park, to be honest. But they're really cool. Right, let me just see these. Oh, it's gone. Let's go see. think this might be... No. Might be... Where's he gone? Where's that one gone? Oh, the two up here. Oh, yes, yes, yes. Look, let's go. Oh. oh, dear. They're so fast. They're so faster. Oh, he's off. Look. Look at that. Oh, look at that. It climbs walls. Get off. Did I just kill it? Oh, it's escaped. Oh, my. That learned to climb that straight away. They're going to be out of here before we know it. Right, I'll have to do something with that. So there we have it. Oh, look at that. Oh, so good. So good. Where have you gone now? Oh, the second one's out as well. Third one's out. Oh, my. Right. That has got to go. It's that there. They escaped via that there. Can't believe it, can you? Escaping dinos, but never mind. Right, well, thank you very much indeed, guys and girls, for watching. Hope you've enjoyed that. It's a long episode in terms of how it took me to make it, but I've got a lot on as well. And hopefully you like that. So thank you very much indeed for watching. Another episode very soon. I'm still thinking about exactly what I'm going to do. But what I might end up doing is I might just end up doing that pathway, just to put the pathway in so we know where it goes. Because then I'm going to cut and paste that, and then I might put the building in over there. And also need to go to Isla Sauna, need to finish the bridge over there. Ooh. That's supposed to be that big, the water. Oh yeah, it is, because the path goes down the side of it. Whoa, I haven't done the bridge as well, so we need to. Oh, I haven't done the garden at the front either, so it's still quite a lot of things to do, guys and girls. Right, thank you very much for watching. If you haven't done so already, go and press that like button for me. It just gets the videos noticed. I want more people to know. The people that do find me, thank you very much for joining us, and welcome. A number of people have found me for the first time, and do share it out, please. I will continue this series. Bye for now.